on.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome back to theCUBE's live coverage of NetApp Converge 2025 here at the MGM in Las Vegas. I'm your host, Rebecca Knight, alongside my co-host and analyst, Rob Strechay. Rob, you're a bit of a Formula One fanboy, am I right?
I love Formula One. I get up early on the Sunday mornings to watch. I watch some of the qualifying on Saturdays, and whatever I can, I catch up online, so yeah.
Well, this one is going to be a special treat for you because we have Stuart Bailey, Head of Infrastructure at Aston Martin Formula One on the show. Welcome, Stuart.
Thank you very much, great to be here.
And Cesar Cernuda, President of NetApp, of course, welcome back to theCUBE.
My pleasure to be here with you.
So, Cesar, I'm going to start with you. Since the partnership between NetApp and Aston Martin Formula One kicked off in 2021, how has it evolved? How has it changed, and what are you most proud of about this?
Actually, you use the right word, being proud. I want to say thank you, Stuart, for your trust.
Thank you.
We feel proud on the partnership. The way this started, actually, was what, 4 years plus ago? This is your fifth season, right?
Yeah.
In Formula One, and we started since they started. So it was a big trust for them to us, and we've been learning with them. The way everything started, because I was here, actually was how we can help Aston Martin Formula One to build an intelligent infrastructure that can really help them to make the best decisions, not just on the track, but also on the headquarters as well, right? And that was kind of the first year's journey. And that partnership has been evolving in a way that we've been using high-performance computing to really help in the different simulations of the different components for the cars to really help them compete, and be better. So thank you for the trust.
Thank you.
And Stuart, I think, again, there's so much data out of these cars, and I just am curious at how this partnership has really helped, Aston Martin, Formula One, and really hit your performance and your strategic goals that you have.
I think it's fair to say it's been transformative. It's been a transformative partnership for us. It's really allowed us to consolidate our infrastructure. We were, historically we dealt with a lot of legacy stuff that we needed to get off. We've helped to, deploy the intelligent data infrastructure, as they say, and it feels like we've, certainly over the last, year, 15 months, it's been transformational. We've deployed so much change. It feels like we've deployed almost everything in NetApp's product catalog. We put ASA and C-Series into the wind tunnel, so a brand new wind tunnel facility, £90 million investment, transformative change there. We deployed Storage Grid to start give us that that insight into our long-term data trends and help build a platform for the future for AI and such things. We've put FlexPod into the main campus, and that now is now connected, integrated with our trackside FlexPods, allowing seamless data transfer from the track to the factory, which just helps with in making that real-time decisions at critical times. And that's across the whole business as well. We put a FlexPod into the test team as well. Yeah. So we've really been on a journey the last year in particular.
Do you see it giving you a competitive edge from that perspective, or how has that worked out?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's been instrumental. If you put the right data in the right place and have the right people having access to it at the right time, that just drives innovation across the business from the design office through to manufacturing, our production office, our wind tunnel teams, our simulation teams. So CFD and FEA are massive for us. And then all the way out to the track as well. And we generate huge amounts of data. We're a petabyte scale organization. Everything's a giant feedback loop. So everything we build and develop at each stage feeds back into the development of the car.
I think the partnership, one of the greatest things is precisely what we're talking right now. We have teams working together, listening to each other to understand the needs. And we try and fail things together as well, right? So I think many times we took, these partnerships to help us with other customers as well. Because that's the type of relation that we're looking for. When we go and say, hey, what are your real needs? How we're trying to help you to solve them, but that requires not just Stuart coming saying, I need this product. What Stuart is saying is, we have these needs, let's team up, both companies, to find those solutions.
Yeah, it's all about business outcome, yeah? So,
absolutely.
Yeah, so the team, the account team have been, they're trusted advisors for us.
Well, both Formula One and tech are insanely competitive spaces. So how, I'm so curious, when you're talking about this culture and these teams coming together, trying to solve these problems, would you say that the culture of NetApp is similar to the culture at Aston Martin Formula One, and just in the sense of how you work together, how you solve problems together?
Well, 100%. What I will say is, that's very interesting because many of our customers talk about their mission critical applications. Many of our customers are asking NetApp, you know, say, what we need is to build an intelligent data infrastructure that can really help to operationalize and work with their data anywhere. And it's very interesting because that's precisely what Aston Martin Formula One needs. And if you see a race, a millisecond, right? Forget a second, a millisecond will make a huge difference. So if we're not able to go and provide them, you know, the reliability that they need on their data, the performance, the scalability, the security, they will not be able to go and do what they're doing every day. So what I'll say is, of course, there's a great integration, but I'll say, you know, this partnership, which is probably more visible when you think about Formula One speed, but most of our customers are asking us the same that Aston Martin Formula One is asking from us.
So you don't have to be in motorsports to be obsessed with.
I'll be honest with you. Sometimes they stress us a little bit, right? but that's great, because one of the great things about NetApp is we like to be humble and have that growth mindset so we can serve our customers better, because at the end of the day, that builds trust.
Exactly. Yeah.
So how from a perspective, because again, you're all over the place. You're using it on the main campus, you're using trackside now with the wind tunnels. Yeah. How really has like the cloud infrastructure helped to elevate that within the campus, and how does that help you in general?
Yeah, so the intelligent data infrastructure really supports our hybrid cloud architecture. So I alluded to the right data in the right place, but it's the right applications in the right place at the right times as well. So it's, you know, it enables us to rapidly scale up to meet business demands, and the business demands only ever go one way, right? It's only ever going up. But it really helps enable, you know, real-time collaboration at every stage of the process, yeah.
So, Cesar, beyond motorsports, what are the broader trends that you're seeing in cloud infrastructure, and how are they impacting industries in general? I mean, you talked about how the learnings from Aston Martin Formula One are also applicable to other industries, too.
Here's what we see across the globe. I think the world has really embraced hybrid. We've been talking all these years about cloud. For many years, we talk about the on-prem world. But the real truth is, most of the companies, what they need is to become and be hybrid. There's data they want to have in their own instances, there's data they want to have in the public cloud, and the biggest challenge that they're facing is interoperability about, you know, among all that data. And that's one of the biggest differentiations that we have as NetApp, because we're truly hybrid cloud. Everybody talks about hybrid cloud, but the reason why I say we're unique is because we're the only company on the planet that since years ago have become, you know, first party service provider. In other words, we have brought our technology into the hyperscalers, not into one or two, but the three largest hyperscalers, meaning Microsoft, AWS, and Google Cloud. You know, our technology is embedded. So in other words, when Aston Martin Formula One wants to run any application or some of their workloads in a public cloud, you know, they're using our technology and they can interoperate if they want to use it on-prem or use it in both worlds. And that's truly a big differentiator. And we see that across the globe.
And I think, again, you know, it's a results-based industry that you're in, and you had 7 podiums last year. And I think, again, when you look at that, what insights are being driven out of NetApp that are helping you with that?
Every aspect of the business is reliant on it to some extent, and it's invaluable in that respect. So we generate data in the design office. We produce 35,000 CAD drawings a year. The car's made up of 15,000 parts. There's a lot of assemblies, a lot of drawings going to come out of that. And then we put that into our simulation and testing environment, so we're getting data out of that as well. And then it goes to the track, it goes in the wind tunnel. And so one of the things we really need to do is look for the correlation across all of those things to try and align those development goals with what it actually produces in terms of car performance. It's about the right data, right place, right time, the right people having access to it.
Then bringing intelligence to that data is the most important thing, right? Yeah. So we'll really try to work with Aston Martin Formula One team is how can we bring that intelligence so they can make better decisions, faster decisions to help their pilots to be faster.
So how are you continually pushing these boundaries of innovation, Cesar? Because I mean, this is, every millisecond counts, this is insanely competitive. You need to make sure that you are on the forefront and exploring technologies and staying there. How do you do it? I mean, you talked about the continuous innovation, the growth mindset, but what are some ways that you are helping not only Aston Martin Formula One, but other clients?
Well, first of all, we've been in the market for more than 33 years. That requires innovation, that requires investment in R&D, that requires a good listening skills, understanding what are the customer needs. We have AI embedded in our products, and with machine learning. In other words, we understand how our customers are using our technology, so that can help us improve our technology on their needs. We have partnerships and works together, our R&D team with customers, in this case with Aston Martin Formula One, where we try to get ahead of the curve. And the example that I gave before, which is also how do we leapfrog the market? When we decided 7-8 years ago, say, why are we going to fight against the cloud? What we're going to go and do is just the opposite. Mm-hmm. Let's bring our technology to the cloud. And that required many millions of dollars of innovation and investment. But nobody else has been able to do that. And today we proudly can say we're, you know, the only company that can really build that intelligent, that infrastructure, you know, in any of the three hyperscalers and on-prem.
So Stuart, kind of, take us through an example, if you could, about where, you know, Aston Martin has really benefited and gained the support of NetApp to help you conquer some innovation that you were looking to do.
I think if you were to turn up at our campus and see Building 3, which houses our wind tunnel, that's probably the biggest, most visual representation of that. That wind tunnel is a game-changing piece of kit, essentially. We had been using Mercedes Grand Prix's wind tunnel. We could only use that at the weekends. So now we've got our own tunnel on site. It's been in use since January of this year. And last year, we put all built the IT infrastructure to support that. We put C-Series and ASA in there to manage the file and block workloads, respectively. And that tunnel now is generating thousands of images on every run, gigabytes of telemetry data, and we can take all of that, and it's on campus, it's all available to go. We don't have to sync it across a WAN anywhere. It's right there for our engineers to be able to access immediately as it's coming off the tunnel in real time. So that's been a big game-changing capability there.
So beyond the wind tunnel, Stuart, what are some of the things that excite you about the potential of this partnership going forward, maybe in the next 5 or 10 years?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's incredibly exciting. That sounds quite geeky, but I think the opportunity is almost endless. You know, I think we're in a position now where we're looking at what the AI opportunities would be in Formula One with NetApp. NetApp are backing us on that. You know, it's we're very much at the stage where we're looking at what workloads could fit in terms of prediction, and a project we have in flight right now is refreshing our, you know, deploying our next gen HPC capability. Yep. It's a high performance compute, so it runs our CFD analysis, which is all to do with understanding how airflow moves over the car, and FEA as well. So that's finite element analysis, how the car reacts to external loads and pressures and forces and things. And so it's an incredibly exciting time to be part of the team, and I'm looking forward to it. There's never a dull day.
Are any of these findings counterintuitive when you come up with and you look at what the data is telling you about how wind is affecting the car or the driver's
speed? Oh yeah, for sure.
Or...
I mean, the cars are incredibly complex at the moment, particularly under the current regulations of ground effect vehicles. So there's always things we're going to learn. And so having that tunnel available to us and that next gen HPC is really going to help us glean insights that are going to help develop the car. Sure.
Yeah, and you were talking about before we got on here about just the sheer volume of data, yeah, not only just from the wind tunnel and from engineering, but even just in a race situation.
Yeah.
And how much do you think you're, you know, per?
Oh yeah, I mean, from a race, typically we'll come back from a race with 150 terabytes of data.
Wow.
So it's roughly 40 or 50 terabytes of data per car for, you know, just in telemetry data. Plus there's a load of video data. There's a lot to manage and a lot to maintain and a lot to then analyze subsequently.
Yeah. Which doesn't sound humanly possible. I mean, I know that AI will do a lot of the analyzing for you too, but in terms of just knowing what's important and knowing what it was, what were the factors that made all the difference?
We got a lot of smart people.
All right, okay.
There's a whole army of people.
And great technology.
Absolutely, it's a partnership, right? Yeah. It's almost symbiotic. So yeah, we're 1,000+ people at the campus. So there's a big headcount there, and it's grown substantially over the last 18 months.
So Cesar, I'm going to give you the final word in terms of how you envision the future of data and technology transforming industries and driving toward the future. I got a bit of a pun in there, right?
No, that's great.
Yeah.
Look, there's no doubt that we're generating more data than we ever did, right? And the biggest challenge that we see, not just in Aston Martin Formula One, but in the entire industry, and our customers is, what do I do and how do I take advantage of all this data? And certainly, all of them are thinking about AI. And one of the things that I tell every single customer is, don't be confused. What you need to do is bring AI into your data, not the other way around. What that means is, you need to go and build your intelligent data infrastructure. You need to modernize your overall data center, your systems, to ensure that you can take advantage of AI. And not the other way around, which many companies are going through a very complex environment. So one of the things that I feel proud about the partnership is we've been preparing Aston Martin Formula One to really take advantage of all the new great things that we're going to be doing with AI to help them compete better, make better decisions, and hopefully do more than 7 podiums in the next
okay,
12 months.
We're gunning for 8, maybe more. Stuart, Cesar, thank you so much for coming on theCUBE. A really fun conversation.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I'm Rebecca Knight for Rob Strechay. Stay tuned for more of theCUBE's live coverage of NetApp Converge 2025. You're watching theCUBE, the leader in enterprise tech news and analysis.